Take your time.
One of the biggest ones, honestly.
Yes.
Pussy. High school, I wasn't really one to fight a lot. Okay. So, because I wasn't one to fight a lot, I really didn't rep most of the gangster culture that existed during the time, because my mother and father raised me so that I didn't do that. I called pussy a lot of times because I avoided fights. It's actually us, because society tends to follow a lot of what black culture tends to do.
So you think a lot of the black culture...
A lot of it, yeah.
How do you think we're going to eradicate labeling amongst our people?
You want to be honest with you?
Yes.
You can't.
She took me to her friend's house, and her friend asked me where I was from. And I said, Guyana, it's in South America. So usually the label would be Caribbean. She called me, she said, oh, you're a coconut. And I was like, what does that mean? She goes, you're a coconut. And I was like, I don't know. I can't compute at the moment. And she goes, no, that means you're from the Caribbean. You're a coconut. And I said, oh, okay. I was highly offended. Yes, it hurt. Yeah, I wanted to cause violence and ruckus. And there's always going to be a label because humans have to call, they have that name something all the time. So there's always going to be a label.
Others would always label me. They would call me like pig, like fat, whatever. I mean, being as young as I was, I was sensitive towards it. But as I grew older, like, I started to not really pay attention to what they said. Sometimes people say it's not to offend you. They're saying it in a friendly manner. Like, friends will say, if I'm your friend and I call you a whore or a bee or whatever, you shouldn't take it to offense because we're on a friendship level, so you shouldn't be offended by it. But I also feel that a female shouldn't allow friends, if they're really your friends, you shouldn't allow them to call you that, even if you're on that level of comfortability. I don't feel that females should allow any male or anyone to call them that.
The worst thing is like, what is it? Not the worst thing, but usually it's like, the dirty and stuff like that. It's like
dirty.
We Haitians, so you must be dirty.
Hardened into the fighting. Like, I know a lot of my friends, like, also Haitian, from Haitian descent, which is fighting every day and doing this and like fight. You know, it's always constant fight, arguments. I kind of learned how to interact, and not interact, but like how to deal with certain adversities. And like,
if somebody had to label you in a positive way, what would that label be?
I would like an achiever, somebody that like young, like a, oh, not entrepreneur, but you know, like somebody that's doing great things.
And it should be like put labels on people in general, but definitely on African American people. And I think that as a whole, we just take these labels and we just like brush it off. But eventually, it comes to define you, even though you don't even know. A recommendation from one of my teachers, and my GPA was one of the highest grades, GPAs among all my African American friends. And my teacher straight out said, oh, I'm surprised. Like, he was surprised that my GPA was just as high.
And this was a Caucasian teacher, white teacher.
Yes.
To be a doctor and you're black. Good luck with that.
And you're black.
Yeah.
Do you think that she was putting you in a box or defeatist label that you already defeated before you even tried? Because society is not going to accept you as being that doctor or whatever you want to be to achieve the level of success that you know you can achieve.
In an environment where blacks or Afro-American people label each other, it's kind of like degrading.
Give me a label. Give me
nigger. It's like, I don't want to talk about it because it's so hurtful to talk about it. Being hurtful when your own kind label you based on your color of your skin.
So your own kind, own brothers and sisters did this.
Yes. And believe it or not, I try my best to look past it, but be honest, it's difficult to look past something that actually strikes you to your core.
To your core.
And honestly, it's like, blacks have a lot of power. We have the ability to be anything we want in this world.
Yes.
But the one thing we're missing is that bond where we don't connect with each other.
I used to be called Cal a lot. Fat bitch.
Say that name again.
Fat bitch.
Okay.
I sort of became introverted, and I didn't want to put myself out there in terms of meeting people. And right now, it's still a struggle for me to do that. And the fact that I was teased about my weight so often is the reason why.
You think you're a beautiful black woman?
No.
So, I was called a nigger.
I was called a nigger too.
And what are you? Give me a positive.
I am a African American.
Illiterate.
Illiterate.
Yes.
And how did you grow? What
They think I'm not, I don't go to school and stuff. They like asking me like, you don't go to school. I'm like, I do go to school. So
why would they call you illiterate?
I have no idea.
Wait, friends or?
It was a complete stranger.
Complete, okay, so how?
They didn't say it like that, but like you kind of figure, you kind of like know what they're trying to say.
So what did they kind of say?
They kind of say like, you know, are you like stupid
we're in conversation in,
yeah, like
in conversation were you with your friends when they
yes
all right yes. What would they call you now? Positive,
intelligent, strong, motivated,
and a beautiful black woman.
And a beautiful black woman, yes. Yeah.
Boys and girls, listen up. You can be anything in the world, and God we trust. An architect, doctor, maybe an actress, but nothing comes easy. It takes much practice. Like, I met a woman who's becoming a star. She was very beautiful, leaving people in awe. Singing songs, Lena Horne, but the younger version. Hung with the wrong person, got a stronger than her. When cocaine, sniffing up drugs, all in her nose. Could have died so young, now looks ugly and old. No fun, cause now when she reaches for hugs, people hold their breath, cause she smells of corrosion and death. Watch the company you keep and the crowd you bring, cause they came to do drugs and you came to sing. So if you're gonna be the best, I'ma tell you how. Put your hand in the air and take the vow. I know I can,
I know I can
be what I wanna be,
be what I wanna be.
If I work hard at it,
if I work hard at it,
I'll be where I wanna be. Boys and girls, listen again. This is for grown-looking girls who's only 10. The ones who watch videos and do what they see. As cute as can be. Up in the club with fake ID. Careful for your meeting.